You've seen this before on the show. That rocket, that right there, that is the rocket ship that will take humans one day to Mars. Mm. I don't know whether it brings them back or not, but that's what the design is here. Leroy Chiao is with us. Now, he's a former NASA astronaut and joins us this morning. Leroy, welcome to the show. It's good to see you, sir.
Oh, good to be here. Thank you.
Is it truly realistic for a human to go to Mars? I would have thought it would have taken years and years and years and years and years, and I'm not sure you can come back.
Well, the technology is mature. The fact is we have the technology to be able to put together a Mars mission. You know, it's not a matter of computers. It's not a matter of propulsion or anything like that. It's a matter of having the money, the resources, and the will to go ahead and do that. And Elon Musk, I think, is putting all of that together. So it is very exciting. What you saw there was a prototype of what will become his Starship spacecraft that he's working on. And it's an ambitious goal, to be sure. But what I've learned is not to count him out. And
how long would it
might take?
Take
a little longer, but if you ask Elon Musk, it's going to take 5 years. From now till 5 years before he launches this mission.
Yeah,
he's ambitious.
Well, let's say, once you've launched this thing, and I don't know whether you would be in it or not, but once you're off and running, how long does it take to get to Mars?
Oh, okay. So once the planets are aligned, you know, we have, of course, different orbits. But once we're aligned and the distance between Earth and Mars is the shortest, we're talking about 6 to 8 months one way. And so it's about what we're doing stint-wise on the International Space Station these days. And that's not a coincidence. Hmm. You know, we're looking at the effects on the human body for that transit time between the Earth and Mars.
So this is feasible. That's fascinating. I thought it was years and years and years to get all the way out there to the red planet, but apparently not. Would you, bearing in mind your experience of being in space, would you go to Mars?
I would go to Mars to explore, but I definitely want to come back. I enjoy living here on the Earth. Elon Musk wants to live on Mars. Of course, he has a plan to colonize Mars. Yeah. And, it's a very ambitious one, but I'd want to come back for sure.
You spent a long time in space. Can you just summarize real fast? What was the impact on you and your body?
Right, so there are a lot of biomedical effects that happen to the human body in space, and none of them are good. So we're exposed to higher levels of radiation, and we won't really know if that's going to have an effect until years down the road. There are other, less important things that happen, but one of the things that has been in the news for several years is astronauts are coming back with changes to their eyesight, and in some cases, permanent damage to their eyes. And so we don't have a full handle on what's going on. We've got some good ideas, but that's just one example of things that happen as we fly longer missions in space, farther away from the Earth. We find these biomedical problems that we hadn't anticipated.
I find it just fascinating. And Leroy, we really appreciate you coming on the show today to share your experiences with us. We do appreciate that. Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Come again, okay? Got it.